The second last performer of the night is one of Ireland's premier musicians, and he's here tonight to discuss the relationship between himself and rhythm, and I suppose the rhythm of Cork music. Ladies and gentlemen, Éamonn Cagney.
Thanks, Mike. I'll take this off. How's it going? Enjoying? Well, I think it's been great. I've been really enjoying everybody, and I've actually seen people I've seen around, and I never knew who they were until they came up and started talking. I go, right, okay. I only have a short thing I'm going to say, and then I'm going to invite a friend on stage, and we're going to play for you. But I did want to say something about drumming. So drumming is what I do, hand drumming, percussion, and it's been with me for about 20 years. And when I started, the drum I've had the longest is about 15 years ago, djembe, it's a West African hand drum. And the first time I saw someone playing one of them, I had never seen it before. It was 20 years ago, so I suppose the internet wasn't happening in any big way. Think about it though, you know? So I saw someone playing it and had never seen it before. So it was like, ah, cool. And he was busking. And I was totally like not going to approach. It was kind of like, ooh, big strong guy playing djembe. I didn't know what it was called. So then about 6 months went by and I saw someone else. And then the frequency of occurrence of this drum just seemed to keep coming more rapidly until eventually I was playing one. A friend of mine's was like, oh, yeah, oh, this is nice, cool, yeah, great, oh, fantastic. What's it called? Oh, I don't know. I think it's called a bongo. So this was not in Cork, it was in Dublin. So I began to learn how to drum by busking and playing with a few other people who were also learning to drum by busking. So we made money, so it was kind of interesting. But when we started, the only drum you could get was an Egyptian darabuka, which is like a little cast aluminium drum that you could buy in this shop called The Nile. And so we all bought them. I tell you, we sounded bad. Oh, it was like banging plastic, you know, tightly, you know. So we had to find a solution, which was we actually wanted to see African drums and we wanted to play them. So I came, so there's no internet. So there's no search engine for how you find it. So I go, okay, how am I going to do it? It really is like meant to be. That just some piece of paper just fell down in front of me and it was like, West African drums for sale in West Cork. So I hitchhiked. Does anybody hitchhike? Remember hitchhiking. So I hitchhiked from Dublin to Cork, and then Cork to West Cork. It took a long time. It took a really long time. I went up to this place called Ballyban. I think it's Sam McNichol here. Anyone from West Cork might know it's near Ballydehob. And there was a guy selling djembes up there. I was like, wow, and I bought one, and it was like, it wasn't even good. But it was still great. So that's 20 years ago, and my talk has now run out of time. But I suppose what I wanted to really say, and it's become very simple, I started then by playing. And play was the word that I didn't think I was going to have a career, I just thought I was going to play and just see what happened. And it went a lot of places, went around the world. I've seen drumming, what it means to people. I've seen it like it means healing for people, it means celebration, togetherness, all the things that people have been talking about tonight. It means a lot of things to a lot of people. But the one thing that it really means for everyone is it's something that you play, and play is just so beautiful and so deep and so serious and so fun. So we're gonna play for you now. I'd like to welcome Tomas Gall, who's going to help me with this. We're going to do two pieces. I'm going to do a solo piece, called Blissful Fire, and then we're going to do a second piece called YAO, which, yeah, you'll hear.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.